Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. It's time to talk about Xiudao again. I have received a lot of great feedback on the 12 Xiudao videos on my channel. With today's video begin the 13th. Thank you all for your support. I really appreciate it. As many of you already know, it's not that easy to explain Xiudao topics in an authentic way due to the nature of this practice. Throughout history, many Xiudao branches have existed with each of them using different terms to express the same concept and the practices. This makes the introduction and the explanation of Xiudao topics very challenging. All of the traditional Xiudao documents were written in classical Chinese or Wenyanwen. What makes it even more interesting is that the ancient Xiudao practitioners used cryptic language to describe the profound meanings of those terms and concepts in order to restrict the practice only to a certain few. In ancient times, Xiudao practice was considered a path to understand human life and the secret of the universe. That's why those documents were written in a way which confounded most readers. There are many other reasons behind this phenomenon. For instance, a popular belief in Xiudao tradition was that one would get punished by the universe if the practice was taught to an unqualified person. But personally, I believe that in modern times, Xiudao practice can benefit many people and it should be promoted. Ideally, it would be a great thing if more and more people get benefits from it. If you are new to this channel or if this is my first Xiudao video you are watching, I recommend you check out my Xiudao playlist. Link is in the description. Even though each Xiudao video in this channel is standalone and focuses on a specific topic, it is still part of the whole and is related to other parts. So, I recommend you watch them all to get the comprehensive picture. In today's video, I'd like to introduce a concept that is unheard of to most of you. 毛有周天. Zhou Tian or Orbit is a key concept in Xiudao practice. I have introduced Zhou Tian in a prior video. Link is in the description. Most practitioners commonly understand Zhou Tian to be only about the upward and downward energy flow along the front and back of the body. People often call it Xiao Zhou Tian or small orbit practice. Now, the question is, are there other types of Zhou Tian in Xiudao? The answer is yes. More importantly, some of them are critical parts of Xiudao practice. And Mao You Zhou Tian is one of them, and I will introduce it today. Topics covered in today's video include, first, review of Zhou Tian. Second, ancient Chinese timekeeping. Third, Mao You Zhou Tian. Fourth, function of Mao You Zhou Tian. Fifth, how to practice Mao You Zhou Tian. Sixth, practice time. And seventh, takeaways. So, without any further ado, let's get started. First, review of Zhou Tian. As I mentioned earlier, I have already introduced Zhou Tian in depth in a prior video. Regardless, let me replay a part of that video so that you can get a basic idea. So, what is Zhou Tian? Well, originally, Zhou Tian was a term used in Chinese astronomy, and people still use this term in China even today. Chinese astronomy has had a very long history. According to scientific and historical research, its origins can be dated back to the Shang Dynasty, approximately 1600 BCE. People found some oracle bones with Chinese star names, such as 28 mansions carved on them. Later, detailed astronomical observations records have been found that show that ancient China has some of the most persistent and accurate observers of celestial phenomena anywhere in the world. More than 1,000 years ago, Indian astronomy reached China with the spread of Buddhism, and both systems incorporated together in China. As a result, Chinese astronomy evolved further quickly after the Tang Dynasty. In the following dynasties in China, many astronomers worked hard to improve astronomical knowledge. Even today, China continues to be active in this field, including its own space program. To understand the relation among the sun, the moon, and the stars, the ancient Chinese astronomers invented many devices, including armillary sphere, abridged armillary celestial globe, water-powered armillary sphere, and celestial globe tower, true north and planetary motion, and many more. One of them was Zhang Heng, a Chinese polymath. He was a scientist, statesman, poet, philosopher, politician, literature, and of course, an astronomer. According to written records, he invented the hydraulic motor-powered armillary sphere, an astronomical instrument representing the celestial sphere. In this instrument, a circle-shaped part implode 365.24 degrees, representing the movement of the sun, and another circle-shaped part represents the change of the day and the night. Now, let's go back to Zhou Tian, the term itself. Zhou means cycle, and Tian means universe. Together, Zhou Tian means cycle of the universe. In the context of the armillary sphere, Zhou Tian is the metal circle in the equipment representing the movement of the moon and the stars. The ecliptic, the bigger the circle on the celestial sphere representing the sun's annual apparent path during the year. Another important one representing daily motions is part of the equipment as well. So, I hope you now have a basic idea of Zhou Tian. Xiu Dao practitioners throughout history have used Zhou Tian to explain and guide the internal energy refinement process, which is the key aspect of most Xiu Dao practice. The most popular practice involves moving the energy downward along the front side of the body and moving the energy upward along the back side of the body. Now, let's introduce another important piece of knowledge before introducing Mao You Zhou Tian, which is the timekeeping method used in ancient China. Second, ancient Chinese timekeeping. The traditional timekeeping system used in ancient China is called Ganzhi, or stem and branch. This system divides a day into 12 even slots, and each slot, called Shi Chen, equals 2 hours. They also gave each time slot a zodiac sign named Chinese zodiac time. In writing, each Shi Chen is expressed by a Chinese character. This is a 时辰 plate. In the interest of time, I will not go into the details of different ancient Chinese timekeeping methods. So, let's just talk about the simple 干支 concept. Take a look at this plate. The top one is 子, going from 2300 hours to 059 hours. And the opposite to 子 is 午, going from 1100 hours to 1259 hours. So, in 修道, the small circulation of 小周天 is expressed by this direction. Energy moving along the body in a vertical direction is called 子午周天 or 子午 orbit circulation, aka small circulation, or 小周天. Since the connection of the 子 and the 午 indicates the vertical direction of energy flow. Now, let me introduce two more time slots on the plate. The right side of the plate, called Mao, from 0500 hours to 0659 hours, and the left side of the plate, called Yao, from 1700 hours to 1859 hours. For now, just remember these two time slots called Mao and Yao on the plate. I will introduce the application of these two time slots in the next topic. To summarize, the ancient Chinese divided a day into 12 parts, which each part representing 2 hours in modern timekeeping. Now, did these 12 slots only represent the time or other entities as well? That brings us to the next topic. Topic 3. Mao You Zhou Tian. Now, let's talk about Mao You Zhou Tian. Mao and You are two time slots on the plate. If we connect these two time slots together along the sphere of the vertical plate parallel to the body, we get another circle which can move upward and downward as well as sideways of the sphere if we face the plate in a two-dimensional approach. So, in 修道, when energy moves upward and downward along the left and the right side of the body, it is called Mao You Orbit Circulation or Mao You Zhou Tian. So, according to ancient Chinese astrology, Zi Wu and Mao You consist of a sphere-like shape, which represents the universe, or the movements of different stars. Also, ancient 修道 practitioners perceived the human body to be like the universe, and its energy circulation to be like the movement of stars in the universe. Again, 子午 orbit circulation is the circulation along the front and the back of the body, while Mao You orbit circulation is the circulation along the side of the body. Here, these words upward, downward, and the side of the body means that the circulation is usually done inside the body. To summarize, 子午 and Mao You are two pairs of time slots according to the ancient Chinese timekeeping method. 修道 practitioners use these two pairs of time slots to indicate the different directions of energy movement. So, what is the function of Mao You orbit circulation? That brings us to the next topic. Topic 4. Function of Mao You Zhou Tian. The Mao You Zhou Tian or Mao You orbit circulation does not get nearly as much emphasis as the Zi Wu Zhou Tian or Zi Wu orbit circulation. However, If you are serious about your 修道 practice, you cannot afford to ignore 卯酉周天。Now, let me briefly introduce its functions. First, 卯酉周天 is the gateway between 小周天 and 大周天 or small orbit circulation and big orbit circulation. In other words,It is very hard, if not impossible, to reach 大周天 without 卯酉周天. Now, you may be wondering, if it's possible to achieve 大周天 without practicing 卯酉周天? Well, of course you can, but you have to spend a lot more time and effort to reach it if you wish to skip 卯酉周天. Second,修道 practice consists of the concept of 外药 and 内药 or external medicine and internal medicine. Among other things, again, medicine or 药 in 修道 means 精气 and 神 or essence, energy and spirit, which has been introduced in my video titled Supreme Medicine in 修道. Link is in the description.Briefly speaking, 外药 or external medicine is anything tangible, while 内药 or internal medicine is anything intangible in 修道 practice. For example, according to classic 修道 documents such as 性命规旨 or life and spirit guidance, 小周天 helps to gather external medicine or 外药 while卯酉周天 helps to gather internal medicine or 内药 which needs to be refined further in order to achieve much more profound benefits of the practice. Therefore, 卯酉周天 is the way to achieve a deeper energy refinement compared to 小周天 which is the necessary step in order to make the energy body readyfor the upcoming 大周天. So, the aforementioned two aspects tell us how important 卯酉周天 is in 修道. Now, how are you supposed to practice 卯酉周天? That brings us to the next topic. Topic 5, how to practice 卯酉周天.There are different methods to practice 卯酉周天 according to the energy path. I'd like to introduce the most popular method in today's video. Other methods are merely variations of this one. So, after focusing on the lower Dan Tian, energy starts rising. Then, focus on the circulation of the energy flow from the lower Dan Tian area to the left side of the body.Then gradually reach the top of the head, then move down from the right side of the body while focusing on the energy flow. Repeat this movement 36 times, then focus on the lower Dan Tian again after the 36 times of circulation. Then energy moves upward from the lower Dan Tian area.Along the right side of the body to the top of the head, then move downward along the left side of the body and to the lower Dan Tian. Repeat this movement 24 times. Remember, 24 times here, not 36. This is the 卯酉 orbit circulation. It is worth noting that traditionally, 36 and 24 are fixed numbers.However, in practice, they are just symbolic figures. For example, some ancient 修道 documents said that 36 and 24 are numbers of breath. Practitioners can just work on energy circulation as long as 36 and 24 times of breath. So, in practice, you can just follow the proportion between these two directions of circulation instead strictly adhering to the numbers. There are many details practiced along the 卯酉 energy channel. For example, during the energy circulation process, the speed of the shifting your focus is not always the same. For example, you need to move it faster at times and slower at another time, will even pause at some points. There are just some of the specific details of Maoyou practice. I may introduce this detailed practical aspect in the future, but for now, let's focus on the key concept of this practice. Also, worth noting is that even though Ziwu and Maoyou represent two pairs of specific time slots of the day, it does not in any way mean that you practice Ziwu Zhou Tian only during Zi and Wu time slot and Maoyou Zhou Tian during Mao and Yu time slots. Doing so is a big mistake and, unfortunately, a very common mistake. So, you have to be very careful when you read Xiu Dao books. You should never take Xiu Dao texts at the face value, as they often use symbolic language and expressions to conceal the real meaning. I cannot emphasize this enough. Topic 6. Practice time. In this section, I will guide you to practice the Maoyou Zhou Tian. Assuming that you have already established a regular Xiao Zhou Tian practice and made sufficient progress, you are now ready for Maoyou Zhou Tian. Being ready means that you have had the energy riding experience already. Now, let's walk through the actual practice. Choose a quiet place and sit down in a comfortable position. Focus on the lower dantian area. Keep your eyes closed. Use your mind to pay attention to the left side of the body. Gradually, move your attention upward to the left rib cage area. Shift your focus to the left shoulders. Shift your focus to the left side of the head. Next, shift your focus to the top of the head. Now, shift your focus to the right side of the head. Next, shift your focus to the right shoulder. Next, shift your focus to the right side of the rib cage area. Finally, bring your focus back to the lower dantian area. 36 times. After 36 cycles, follow the same cycle in the opposite direction for a total of 24 times. After completing both sets, relax and finally open your eyes. By the way, the speed of the energy circulation is not very slow, since Maoyou Zhou Tian can be a bit faster compared to other practice. As I have mentioned before, there are different ways to practice Maoyou Zhou Tian. They may seem different from each other, but in essence, they follow the same principles and provide the same result in practice. What I have introduced in this section is the most popular method of practicing Maoyou Zhou Tian. I hope you will add it to your practice. Topic 7. Takeaways. First, Zhou Tian means cycle of the universe. Second, the ancient Chinese divided a day into 12 parts, with each part representing 2 hours in modern timekeeping. Third, Ziwu and Maoyou are two pairs of time slots according to the ancient Chinese timekeeping method. Xiu Dao practitioners use these two pairs of time slots to indicate the different directions of energy movements. Fourth, Maoyou Zhou Tian is the gateway between 小周天 and 大周天 or small orbit circulation and big orbit circulation. Also, 卯酉周天 helps to gather internal medicine or 内药 which need to be refined further in order to achieve much more profound benefit of the practice. Remember to check out the practice time section to find out how to actually practice Mao You Zhou Tian. That brings us to the end of today's video. Thank you for watching. See you next time and enjoy your practice.